of BPharm fourth year, studying in Sri Lata Institute of Pharmacy. Today I'm here to explain my view about healthcare associated infections. Healthcare associated infections, they continue to trouble the healthcare industry. Center for Disease Control and Prevention estimates that for every 20 patients, a person gets infected with healthcare associated infection every day. Patients with suppressed immunity are highly susceptible to these infections. However, patient safety networks and organizations have focused on quality, are bonding together to improve infection control and reduce the number of patients who contract these infections. Following is a comprehensive list of the common bacteria and viruses causing healthcare associated infections. And the first one is Acinetobacter baumannii, which is a gram-negative bacillus, which is a pleomorphic and non-motile, and mainly it is found in the ICUs and areas with highly ill people. People with weakened immune system are highly susceptible to transmission, rarely seen outside the healthcare units. It is a gram-negative bacteria, and it has a high incidence among immunocompromised individuals. And coming to the signs and symptoms, it includes pneumonia, bloodstream infections, meningitis, wound and surgical site infections, including flesh eating bacterium, necrotizing fasces, and urinary tract infections. And treatment, generally they are treated with imipenem or meropenem, but a study rise in carbapenem resistant Acinetobacter baumannii has been noted, and this infection was recently treated using phage therapy. And coming to the prevention methods, in healthcare units, mainly focused on increased hand washing and more sterilization procedures. And next, Bacterial fragilis. It is a normal bacteria which is mainly found in the intestinal tract and colon. It is an obligatory anaerobic gram-negative and rod-shaped bacterium. It is a part of normal microbiota of human colon, but can cause infection if displaced into the bloodstream or surrounding tissue following surgery, disease or trauma. Coming to the signs and symptoms, symptoms and signs are very unknown for this disease. And coming to the treatment, it is highly susceptible to metronidazole, carbapenem and beta-lactams and beta-lactamase inhibitor combinations. This bacteria is highly resistant to penicillin and clindamycin. And next, Burkholderia sepatia. It is an aerobic bacteria and gram-negative bacillus, which is mainly found in aquatic environments. It is an organism with a very, very low virulence, and it is used as a frequent colonizer of fluids in hospitals. Coming to the signs and symptoms, it includes shortness of breath, wheezing, coughing, fever, congestion, etc. And treatment, folic catheters are mainly used, and it is contraindicated in patients who are suffering with diabetes and multiple myeloma. And next, Clostridium difficile. It is one of the most well-known healthcare associated infection. It causes inflammation of the colon, and symptoms can range from diarrhea to life-threatening colitis. Antibiotic associated diarrhea is the most common symptom following medication ingestion that eliminates good bacteria from the intestine along with the bad. The bacteria are transmitted via the fecal-oral route, most commonly being transferred from an infection site to another patient by a healthcare provider's hands. It is resistant to many routine cleaning products, including alcohol-based hand cleaners, so it is able to survive in clinical locations for extended periods of time. It can usually be treated with antibiotics, but in some cases, a stool transplant may help restore bacterial imbalances. And next, Clostridium sordidi. It is a rare bacteria which is most often causing infections in patients with underlying medical conditions. The bacteria can cause pneumonia, endocarditis, peritonitis, and myonecrosis. And severe cases can lead to sepsis, which is rarely seen. And it mainly affects women and is often linked to end of pregnancy. Whether the pregnancy results in childbirth, abortion or spontaneous abortion, and its transmission route is still unknown. Treatment, currently a combination combination of penicillin and clindamycin is widely used, and recent studies show that protein synthesis inhibitors such as clindamycin, chloramphenicol, rifampin, tetracycline will be more effective because they inhibit the synthesis of clostridial exotoxins and lessen the local and systemic toxic effects of these proteins. And next, carbapenem resistant Enterobacteriaceae. This the Enterobacteriaceae family is infamous for its resistance to antibiotics, mainly carbapenem antibiotics, a class of antibiotics often used as a final line of defense against infections. These are normally found in the gut but can cause serious infections if they travel to other parts of the body. It can be transmitted via human to human contact or coming in contact with an infected device such as a catheter. And the bacteria have the ability to innately break down carbapenems, rendering the class of antibiotic useless in infection control. These infections can have up to a 50% mortality rate. And for treatment, phosphomycin will be given, which is an antimicrobial agent which acts to inhibit the UDP and acetylglucosamine enolpyruvate transferase, which catalyzes one of the early steps of bacterial cell wall synthesis and is effective against gram-negative and positive aerobic bacteria. And tigecycline is also given, which is a first-line defense against carbapenemase producing isolates. And next, Enterococcus faecalis, another highly antibiotic resistant bacteria, which resistance is inherent. The bacteria contain penicillin binding proteins and are able to bypass folate synthesis, an important step in bacteria elimination. Recently, Enterococcus bacteria have acquired resistance to vancomycin, leaving just a few treatment options for patients. While the bacteria are normally found in the gut, they can cause infection when they spread, notably causing urinary tract infections, sepsis, and wound infections. It is a resilient bacteria with the ability to survive in a temperature range of 50 to 115 degrees Fahrenheit. And coming to the signs and symptoms, it causes abdominal pain, burning when you urinate, vomiting, fast breathing, or shortness of breath, chest pain when you breathe, and stiff neck. And coming to the treatment, ampicillin is a preferred antibiotic to treat this infection. And most severe infections such as endocarditis or meningitis are treated with a combination of antibiotics. And it is sometimes also resistant to vancomycin. And the strains that don't respond to vancomycin are known as vancomycin-resistant enterococcus. In this case, linezolid or daptomycin are treatment options. And next, Escherichia coli, which is another bacteria group commonly found in the gut, but can also become pathogenic. It is a leading because of urinary tract infections in hospitals, but can also cause gastroenteritis, pneumonia, or even neonatal meningitis. The strain is commonly found as a source of infection in patients. Serious infections may lead to hemolytic uremic syndrome, a disease that destroys red blood cells, causes acute kidney failure, and reduces platelet counts. They have inhabited the earth for an estimated 20 million to 30 million years, and it is a very diverse bacteria. Only 20% of its genome is found in all strains, and some researchers suggest it should be taxonomically reclassified. And coming to the symptoms, it includes severe stomach pain, diarrhea, vomiting, and some people may have fever also. And treatment, it is dehydration and replacement of fluids and electrolytes. And administration of antibiotics has been shown to shorten the course of illness and duration of excretion of enterotoxigenic in adults. And next, hepatitis A. It is a least common of the three major hepatitis virus found in the healthcare settings. It is spread through the fecal-oral route, and healthcare personnel are often infected when handling a patient in whom the infection is not yet recognized and is fecal incontinent or has diarrhea. The hepatitis A virus vaccine is strongly recommended for children in the US between the first and second birthdays, and it has proven to be extremely effective in community acquired infections. And symptoms include jaundice, belly pain, vomiting, itching, pale colored poop, joint pain, diarrhea, and fatigue. Treatment, no specific treatment is known until now, and recovery from symptoms following infection may take several weeks or months, and therapy is aimed at maintaining comfort and adequate nutritional balance, including replacement of fluids lost from vomiting and diarrhea. and vaccine, it contains either inactivated hepatovirus A or a live but attenuated virus. Both provide active immunity against a future infection. It is the vaccine to prevent it is about 95% effective in healthy adults and can work for more than 20 years. And in children, it's about 85% effective and can last up to 15 to 20 years. And next, hepatitis B. Cause acute infections or chronic liver function infections. An acute infection typically exhibits liver inflammation, vomiting, and jaundice. Some acute cases can turn into chronic hepatitis B, causing lifelong infection. And cirrhosis, liver cancer, liver failure, and death. It is typically spread through body fluids of an infected person being transmitted into a non-infected person, which in healthcare settings is often through contaminated needles, syringes, or other shots. And the vaccine is also highly effective, mostly when administered to children, as 95% develop protective antibodies. And that protection percentage drops to 90% in age 40 and 75% for people age 65 and above. And next, hepatitis C. Unlike hepatitis A and hepatitis B, there is no vaccine against hepatitis C. While mainly transmitted through intravenous drug use in the community, the healthcare setting sees hepatitis C transmission through contaminated syringes, needles, or shots, infected blood transfusions, and sometimes even organ transplants that have not undergone adequate screening. US implemented blood screening for HCV in 1992, before which blood transfusion was one of the major causes of infection transmission. Now, the risk is approximately 1 in 2 million units transferred, and the majority of people diagnosed, 75 to 85% will develop a chronic infection. In late 2013, US Food and Drug Administration, FDA, approved two separate drugs for hepatitis C treatment, that is Sovaldi and Olisio. And next, influenza. It is a common one, but novel strains not before seen in humans, and variant strains often emerge. The H1N1 strain or swine flu was one of the most recent deadly variants of influenza A virus, and the virus ability to adapt into new strain causes researchers to have to update flu vaccines annually to reflect current influenza trends. While people often come down with the flu, in some severe cases it can lead to death. Treatment medications include like paracetamol to relieve the fever and muscle aches associated with the flu, and the two classes of antiviral medications used against influenza are neuraminidase inhibitors and M2 protein inhibitors. And next, prevention of these diseases is mainly healthcare centers have to maintain hygiene, and every patient must have to develop immunity. Thank you.